Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to install the latest version of IntelliJ IDEA, that is version 2024.1 on a Windows operating system. And after that, I am also going to show you how you can easily create a simple Hello World Java program within our IntelliJ IDEA. So this video is going to be a bit informative, so I'll highly recommend you to watch the video till the end. And if you face any issues in middle, you can always comment in our comment sections, I'll try my best to help you. Now to install the latest version of IntelliJ IDEA, that is version 2024.1, you need to first simply go to favorite browser and to just search over here IntelliJ IDEA download and hit enter. And immediately you'll be able to see this www.jetbrains.com as a first search result. So you have to open this download IntelliJ IDEA. And it's going to automatically redirect to the official site of JetBrains. So this link I'm going to provide right in our description, so you can directly use that link to land over here. And once you are here, you can see that our IntelliJ IDEA is available for Windows, Mac OS and Linux. So you can, you know, use this tab to switch your operating system. So I am going to use it for Windows, so I'm going to, you know, click on this Windows tab, and under that you'll be able to see that our IntelliJ IDEA is available, the ultimate version. So if you scroll down, you'll be able to see the community edition. So this ultimate version will require some license, so you need to buy its product to get that license. And for community version, it is available for all of you. All right, so you need to download this community one, so this require no license, you can use the software, you know, properly. So you need to click on this download button and it's going to start downloading our IntelliJ IDEA, the community edition. So you can see it is rightly started downloading, right? So I have already downloaded it, so I'll cancel this. I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory, and here you can see that our IntelliJ IDEA is already been downloaded over here. So you have to just simply double click on that installer in order to install it locally on your system. And here you need to just simply click on install anyway, and it's going to ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes. And there you go, welcome to IntelliJ IDEA community edition setup. So let's first minimize our download directory. So here you need to just simply click on next. So this is where our IntelliJ IDEA is going to be installed. So you can see you need to have 2.4 gigabyte of free space on your C drive, as we are going to install it on our C drive itself. So everything is fine, just simply click on next. So here under installation options, you can see several checkboxes. So I am going to check it one by one. So I'm going to first select a desktop shortcut, then also add open folder as project. So as soon as you select that, what's going to happen is on right clicking of any folder, it's going to additionally going to show you this option called open folder as project. So automatically when you open that folder in IntelliJ IDEA, so it's going to show that folder as a project on your IntelliJ IDEA. All right, so that's why it is, you know, recommended to select this checkbox. And also you can see that you can use our IntelliJ IDEA for all these different languages. So I'm going to select Java. You can also use it for Gradle, Groovy, Kotlin and all these different languages. And this is the most important part, you need to check this add bin folder to path. Alright, so it is very important to set the environment the variable. So everything is fine now, just simply click on next. So it's going to create a JetBrains folder, which is again totally fine. Just simply click on install, and there you go. You can see our installation is rightly began. So it will take some time, you know, about a couple of minutes. So our desktop shortcut is also created. So now let's wait for a couple of minutes. After that, I'm going to again come back to this video. So we'll come back. And now you can clearly see that our IntelliJ IDEA is rightly installed. Also our desktop shortcut is also created. So now it is telling that you need to reboot your system. So it is highly recommend to, you know, proceed with this reboot now. So after selecting this radio button reboot now, and you click on finish. So when you click on finish, it's going to automatically restart your system. So after successfully restarting your system, I'll be again back to this video. So welcome back. So after successfully rebooting your system, we'll be again landed over to the desktop. So you need to just simply double click on that shortcut to launch our IntelliJ IDEA. And you can see that our IntelliJ IDEA is rightly started launching, that is version 2024.1. And here under data sharing, you can always click on the send anonymous statistics, so that will help to improve our product. So it also provide permission to firewall, so click on allow. And there you go. You can see that our IntelliJ IDEA is slightly opened. So welcome to IntelliJ IDEA. So let's first maximize it. So you can see this is the interface of our IntelliJ IDEA version 2024.1. So you can always create a new project. So for that you need to click on this plus new project. So it's going to show you this new project window. So here you can see that all these different languages are available: Kotlin, Java, Groovy, everything. So you can always create a Spring project as well. So in this video I'm going to create a simple Java project. So I'm going to select Java and I'm going to name this project as Hello World, and all other things are fine. You can see that our default JDK version 22, they have properly recognized at this folder path. So in my previous videos I have showed you how to install Java. So that time I have installed Java at this location. So you can see under detected JDK, it is properly recognized that path. But for you, if you don't have Java installed, then you can always download your latest version of Java using this button. So that will going to fetch all the files from internet and going to install it locally on your system. So you don't need to manually install Java separately. So in your IntelliJ IDEA are going to do that for you. Alright, so that also you can do. Since I have already installed, so that is what it is automatically detected. So I don't need to do anything. So everything is fine now. So it's going to also create a sample generate code. So everything is fine. Click on create and it's going to start creating our project. And you can see that our Hello World project, that is main.java file, is also created. So here is our printf method, system.out.printf, and we have a hello and welcome note, and then it's going to print number from 1 to 5. You can see we have a loop, right? So that is it going to run from 1 to 5 and it's going to print number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sequentially. So everything is fine. It's going to start indexing our JDK. You can see it is currently indexing our JDK. So let's wait for a couple of minutes and you can see that our indexing is properly done. You can always maximize our IntelliJ IDEA. So you can see it is properly indexed. You can always click on this run button, so that will going to start building our project. And once it gets successfully built, it's going to show you the output hello and welcome, and then number from i 1 to 5, it is printing, right? So let's say you don't need this loop, so you can totally remove this and you can just only keep something like hello world over here. So hello world. And after writing this much, if you just simply click on this run button, it's going to again start building our project. And after it gets successfully built, it's going to show you the output hello world on your console. So you can always start creating, you know, different projects for your assignments probably that you have got from your school or college. So you can immediately start, you know, writing all the projects within our IntelliJ IDEA. All right. So hopefully these videos are helping you. I have also started Geeky Syntax channel. So here regularly I am posting coding related videos. So please do subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel as well. And also if you are interested, you can also subscribe our Geeky Script blogging channel as well. So that is basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video and God bless you all.